working in the lab late one night, when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise...
Welcome, boys and girls, to our spooktacular show! We have ghosts and witches, monsters galore,
skeletons and Frankensteins, and much, much more!
Hold on to your seats, don't be afraid, we're starting the show with a costume parade.
It's Halloween! It's Halloween! The moon is full and bright! And we shall see what can't be seen on any other night!
Skeletons and ghosts and ghouls!
Grinning goblins fighting duel!
Werewolves rising from their tombs!
Witches on their magic brew!
In masks and gowns we haunt the street and knock on doors for trick or treat!
Tonight we are the king and queen, for oh, tonight it's Halloween.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Comedy Cafe. Tonight we have a special show planned for you. Now, let's hear a round of applause for our most famous comedian, Mr. Bone Jangles!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Is it cold in here, or did I just forget to cover up? So the other day, I entered a skeleton beauty contest. You know who won? Nobody. Get it? Nobody. After the beauty contest, I went out to eat with some of the other contestants. I ordered some spare ribs. The waiter suggested a spicy Thai meal, but I told him that I don't have the stomach for it. When the waiter finally brought my order, do you know what he said to me? Bon appetit. Oh, the nerve of that guy. Did he think he was tickling my funny bone? But seriously, you guys, being a skeleton is tough.
How tough is it?
Oh, it's tough. For example, I can never lie. You know why?
Why is that?
Because my parents can see right through me. Plus, people are always judging me. Take my band teacher, for example. I wanted to play the flute, but he insisted I would be better playing the trombone. But that's okay, because me and music, we've never really gotten along. Like, I wanted to play in church, but my pastor wouldn't let me because he said I don't have any organs. Seriously, though, in the winter, being a skeleton is really difficult.
Why is that?
Well, the winter winds blow right through me and chill me to the bone. Plus, when I get invited to Christmas parties, the guests always mistake me for a coat rack. Well, that's all the time I have. Time to go home and rest my lazy bones. Have a good night.
You know, some people said he didn't have the guts to come up here, but I think he did a fantastic job. Next, we have a special guest who only comes out at night. Let's hear another round of applause for Mrs. Count Damien.
I'm so pleased to eat you. I mean, meet you. Excuse me. You know what's worse than a hungry vampire? A thirsty one. But seriously, I loved you. You know what my favorite snack is? A fangburger. But before I eat anything, I like to cut it up into bite-sized pieces. You know, I almost thought I wasn't gonna make it here on time. I rode in the Bloodmobile, and it almost ran out of fuel. Being here around all of you young kids reminds me of when I was in grade school. My teachers would always get mad at me because they thought I was a fangster. Being a vampire can get real lonely sometimes. The other night, I was out with my goal friend, and I got mad at her when she started batting her eyes at another bachelor. She got so mad at me, she tried to bite my head off. Man, she can be a real pain in the neck. Well, that's all the time I have here tonight. I better get out of here before I start coughing. Have a great night, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's hear it for Count Damien. Now, for the first time ever on our stage, let's welcome Mrs. Mummy.
Good evening. Pardon me if I seem a little tightly wound. You know, I find it hard to undifficult in public places. I find that listening to music helps me unwind. I prefer rap. You know, last week, my favorite artist was in town, and my buddy told me I should just dig up any old guy I could find. But I told him, seriously, I'm not that way. Although, you know, I think sometimes people look at me differently. They think I'm too wrapped up in myself. But that's not the case. Anyways, I think my tomb, I mean, my time is up here. So that is a wrap for today, and I hope you guys have a safe and happy Halloween.
That was great. See, boys and girls, Halloween doesn't have to be scary.
That's right. But some of the costumes people wear are horribly frightening. And then when I get home after trick-or-treat and it's time for bed, I start to worry that I might be frightened by The Monster in My Closet by Florence Perry Hyde.
Monster in my closet hides there just for me. He shrieks and moans and rattles bones, just like a skeleton. He always tries to scare me. Tonight I shouted boo at him, and he went up in smoke.
But the monsters in your closet aren't anything compared to A Trip Through the Haunted House by Vic Kroon.
Not a window was broken, the paint wasn't peeling, but a porch step sagged, and there was a feeling that beyond the door and into the halls, this was the house of no one at all. No one who breathed, nor laughed, nor ate, nor said I love, nor said I hate. Yet something walked along the stair.
Something that was, yet wasn't there.
And that is why weeds on the path grow high.
For something walks along the stair. Something that is, yet isn't there.
Have you ever been to a haunted house?
I went once, but I was too frightened to actually go in.
What were you afraid of?
You never know what kind of creatures are lurking about.
Speaking of lurking, who do we have lurking about?
Me? You don't know me? I'm offended.
Sorry, but I have no clue who you are.
Why? I'm only the best witch in the world.
Why, that can't be, because I'm the best witch in the world.
I know. Let's have a contest of curses by Michael Patrick Kern.
Ragwort, Tansley, Parsley Pea, you'd better stay away from me.
Purple Pumpkins, Crabgrass Green, you're the ugliest thing I've ever seen.
6 times 6 and 2 times 2, let your hair turn to blue.
Brooklyn Needle, Jersey Pin, let a war grow on your chin.
You think that's bad? Here's something worse. You'll never get rid of this last curse. Alakablam, a dram of grog, turn that witch into a frog.
This is awful.
Ha! Looks like I showed her.
Do witches always do bad spells?
Well, no.
Do you think you could cast a good spell to keep our audience safe on Halloween?
Well, sure. Mambo Jambo, Tiff and Tafe, keep these children nice and safe.
I guess that's it, folks. Have a great Halloween.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
What's wrong?
Well, we can't just end like this.
Because you missed the best part of Halloween.
What could I have forgotten?
Ask them.
What do you think the best part of Halloween is?
Candy!
Candy's great, but that's not what I was thinking.
Trick-or-treating?
Of course, that's a lot of fun, but I was thinking of something you could do with your parents before Halloween.
Talk about safety?
Nah, that's important, but here, let me give you a riddle.
I'm orange if I'm ready, but green if I'm not. I can be happy, mad, or sad, depending on how you make me. I can feel the intense flame deep down within me. The holes in my face make me glow. What am I?
A jack-o'-lantern!
That's right. Just make sure your parents are helping you when you're carving your pumpkins on Halloween.
Now is the show over?
Almost, but we have one more thing to say.
Have a happy and safe Halloween!
But don't eat too much candy.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
Mash.